here now.
We made it this far.
He's in God's
hands
now.
Let's go.
I have a question for you. I want you to describe what you think Strapped is. In your own words, what is Strapped?
Strapped is Neil and I playing three rounds in 3 days on a tight set budget and just getting out amongst the people. It's Americana.
Yeah, and it's, you know, a $200 round, you know, $220 round at a semi-private,
semi-public. Why do you keep it semi-public?
Mostly private course. That doesn't seem like it's getting out amongst the folks.
Listen, I think DJ can attest that we made a good faith effort to pay for that round. And our money, we were told our money was no good there.
I totally disagree because you budgeted it out like you wouldn't have to pay for it. Budget if you did pay for it.
No, we budgeted for the $60 rate.
Yeah, we did budget
with the
$60
rate, we would have been fine.
But that's why we ended up going to the Willow Motel.
Because we took the money we came into by not paying the $60 rate, and we got.
Where were you going to stay if you didn't stay at the Willow Motel?
Well, we don't know. I don't know. We would have found
that
a cheap
Airbnb. You know what that would have been? Yeah. That would have been good content. That's the content we signed up for.
You guys haven't seen the Willow Motel.
I was going to say, we were concerned about a gas leak, which I think is pretty good content.
We're at the Willow Motel.
Hello, guys.
Hey, how are you?
How are you doing?
Hey!
Some 60 Minutes in here?
Yeah, Mr. 314, good to see ya.
Hey, boys. Smells like natural gas in here.
That's what the big guy said, too.
Really?
Same thing. Yeah, that's concerning.
Like, first thing that comes to my mind, smells like gas in here.
Well, it's probably that thing. I mean,
well, propane, not natural gas. Natural gas, you don't smell. It's a silent killer.
I don't know, smell that. Huff it.
No, it's not there.
All right, well, I think you should talk to the big guy about it.
All right.
I feel uncomfortable.
I'm a little worried. I think the place smells like gas.
Yeah, the room's great.
Shower's awesome. If you have any questions, call the number of your cell phone. Okay.
258-001. Yeah.
Call me. I'll come.
We'll see.
You.
All right.
I can give you a different room if you want.
No, we're good. Thank you.
The window, and I'll probably be.
It's not gas. We're not going to die.
All right. Thank you.
Are you sure?
Well, allegedly.
Here's the question. If we don't wake up tomorrow, is that like a mega bonus? Or is that like the mega bonus?
It depends what your life insurance policy is.
I mean,
what do you think? Should
like ProTriage Holdings might be getting the mega bonus if you guys die in your sleep.
Well, like an eternity in...
Listen, that's private.
You know, in paradise sounds pretty good,
listen,
all
for
things
sure.
considered.
This is... Like the politics, this isn't the place for you to schlep your beliefs that in sure. that regard.
Let's keep it to golf and natural gas, shall we?
They're like fracking under our room.
What did he say to what?
They've just started the heater.
Which makes sense.
I've smelled that in like old apartments that
for
I've
sure.
been
like
in before.
That adds up.
And he said, just crack the window. You'll never smell it.
All right. Guys, I need to have a serious talk with you.
Yeah.
I know you're ready to go to bed. I know you don't want to do this. But I was going through the budget again, and you guys were getting kind of like jolly.
We got $14 left.
Well, yeah. You told us we could be jolly.
I'm not here to lecture you guys. That's not what this is. But this is... I think kind of a little lesson in like personal finance and how quickly things can snowball.
And we got out of our skis. Like maybe we bought the Dodge Charger and we probably should have bought the Toyota Camry.
Yeah.
And we put some rims on it. Maybe we got 212s in the back.
Can I say what the issue was from my perspective?
Sure.
I think the hotel was quoted at $100, which we always quote
as a
threesome.
And then
we back out DJs.
Yeah.
And he had already backed out his share.
The producer got...
When he quoted us at 100.
Got his own room.
That's a little scummy. He's trying to create storylines where they're...
Yeah.
Where they're
it's really just his storyline.
Yeah.
He's a selfish...
He's Kristoff.
Yeah, he is. One thing you're forgetting? You know what it is. There's a mega bonus. So we're just going to win $500 tomorrow. We're
both shooting under par for $1,000.
Let's go.
Nothing I saw today leads me to believe you guys are going to shoot under par tomorrow.
But that's when they least expect it.
It's always darkest before the dawn.
Well said. Whoa! Pro Trash Holdings, this is Neil. Hey, Paul. Yeah, things are great. We cracked the window. The gas seems to be not. No, no, we're good. We're good. We got the yeah, we're sure. Thanks, Paul. See ya. He's just making sure that we didn't feel uncomfortable with the gas smell. And he says, I said, no, the gas is good. He goes, it's not gas. All right, Paul said we could have a little bit of breakfast. So I might have some Raisin Bran and a little coffee.
So let's talk about that. You got a bunch of stuff you guys stole from Google. You got free breakfast.
We didn't steal it.
We got those little.
That would be ungoogly.
We got the little Apple. Yeah.
I mean, that's part of why you work there.
The Apple donut holes, too.
Yeah, we did. We get free breakfast here, so we got $14 for lunch. So.
The thing to kind of, you know, to set the stage, though, is you only have one golf ball left. If you lose that, then the decision becomes, like, do we want to eat lunch or do we want to pay for you to get more golf balls?
Sounds like there's going to be a lot of places to look for lost Callaways.
Yeah.
That's true.
Right? I think we can find a couple.
And also, like, if you don't play, like, I don't really know what happens. Like,
what are you gonna do?
Yeah, what are you gonna do? Tron.
Wait. You wanna fucking square up? I mean, you tell me.
Do you wanna dance with the foghorn?
Alright, good night, boys.
Alright, see you, bud. Good night, Dad.
Megabus, oh, it's on. My career low is 77, so I'm thinking there's no way I don't shoot like a 70 or 71 today. I'd be shocked if one of us didn't get the mega bonus. We woke up, there was no gas leak, or if it was, it was low enough and diffused enough by the window that we were able to retain consciousness. That was cool. We're going to go tell Paul. He was wondering about the new mattresses. They were firm. I like that. So I'm going to give him 2 thumbs up.
But no, we had to get moving up the road. We were going to Middlebury, Vermont.
Neil, you know what's going on in that coffee shop? The most powerful weapons in the world are in that coffee shop. Ideas.
An exchange of ideas.
I bet it's an exchange of ideas.
It's like an arms race in there.
Yeah.
Just big old ideas.
I'd be willing to say that these Apple donut circles have been the best purchase in Strap history. I'm proud of you, big guy.
I didn't eat that, Bob.
Did he?
Ah, interesting. Everyone talking shit about DJ, now look who comes suckling on the teat when the money's run out.
Has it hit?
Oh, it's coming.
I don't think I've ever listened to Diplo's Revolution.
Oh, you're missing out, man.
Randy?
No, I didn't. I didn't know Diplo's Revolution was going to be televised.
Vermont doesn't know what's coming. They're not ready for the revolution. Now I'm cooking.
That's the fish concert going on over there.
It is, man. Oh, dead farmhouse. Whoa, heavy things. Woo!
Who's got the charms in you, my friend?
Our third and final course was the Middlebury University golf course. And it was cold and a little foggy and wet on a Monday mid-morning. And it couldn't have been more delightful.
Hey, bud.
Hey, chaps.
How are you?
What's happening?
Well, we just got to Middlebury. It was a pretty long drive. The weather's not good.
It's very cold.
Cold and rainy.
It's cold and rainy.
Seems to be quite a theme on these trips.
Yeah, you know, my platonic friend Randy and I we're chilly, so we're about to go out. We're the only guys at the course. Who's in steam, guys? A little bit of the vibe has become very jebby, and it's cold, and we don't want to play.
No, I do.
F*** that.
you. I want to play.
Yesterday was the money round. We lost $40.
What happened up there?
We stunk. Yeah, he's been definitely active.
That's
when he's playing bad, he goes straight to Bumble to get a little pop, you know, in the attitude.
That's very overstated.
You guys enjoy your golf trip. We're gonna hold down the fort out over here.
All right, guys.
All right, thank you.
Bye. Cheers, crack on.
Bye.
Cheers.
Those guys. I'm so sick of them telling me how to live my life.
Well, we thought it was gonna be like $45. There's some extreme discounts, maybe for this time of year, for the weather, for being a Monday morning.
So it was only like $40 total.
Yeah, so we got like $50 more in our budget.
Oh wow,
that's huge.
Well, that would have been nice to know. Now so we can't really do much with it.
Yeah. Well, we can have a nice lunch.
Well, they don't even have a restaurant here.
Well, they got a restaurant. Like
Two Brothers Tavern.
Two Brothers Tavern.
Back in town.
Yeah, you know, I got a long drive home. I can't have too many cold beers.
Oh, no. Well, let's get out there and launch them.
All right, cool.
Us and another, like, threesome of old men were the only people on the course. Fall colors. I made the comment at one point, you know, it wasn't the best course in the world. But like at that time in that place, I think it was the best course in the world. I'm gonna have to workshop that take a little bit.
God, I'm so f***ing stiff. This will be interesting.
Very pretty out here though.
Got a lot of layers on, not gonna get a lot of rotation. We're gonna be hitting knockdowns, scooters, nippers. Excited.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
You know, that round could have easily been felt very lonely and forced, but instead it felt really spiritual, like that was where we were supposed to be.
The home of Ethan Allen and the Green Mountain Boys.
But like, I got to be a Green Mountain Boy for the day.
Yeah, and it's just a place where there's so much history for the country, for golf. And this is the best time of year to see it.
Be good.
Oh.
Almost in.
What a fun shot.
Oh, come on.
Filling up the creek.
Miller. There's a Callaway in these woods. Oh my god, that was I got a little aggressive, but that's a comfy creek.
That was in the creek.
It's always nice when you go and do something like this on like a Monday, and you get a little stressed out, like, oh man,
I feel like I should be somewhere else.
Should be somewhere else, but then he starts, like, today I really got the feeling like, man, like life is going to go on without me. And if you can like establish that, it's a really comforting feeling. Everybody can wait a day. Like, I'll be back tomorrow. It's all good.
I think about, you know, what might have been when I get up to this area of the country. In high school, I went to a basketball camp, like a prospect preview camp at Williams, and thought really long and hard about going there and playing basketball. I also, you know, kind of visited all the NESCAC schools, including here at Middlebury. But, you know, with hindsight, with knowing what I know now, I think I would have ended up at a place like Middlebury, a place like Williams. And that's when it's like, it hits me though, like, I'd never be sitting next to you right now. Had that been the case. So it's like,
and you know, that business school helped you become the CFO of Coach Ashford.
Right. So it's just, it's so kind of a,
that too.
Yeah, it's kind of a little bit of a trip.
Yo, for a little tapping bird.
Look, I'd like to show the viewers this lonely tree.
That's beautiful.
Like, it's just fall. It's Vermont.
Cakes, man.
handle. Let's go!
Woo!
Like those. Just yeah!
Coach letter, this looks like a captain's practice, maybe.
Could be.
Pull out of season. Get the boys out.
Guess what?
Carry on, guys.
Yeah, what's up?
No!
Fly away.
Last ball. 116.
Back-to-back birds to finish for Neil.
That's a Tommy Mansky finish.
Happen it. Finish with your head held up. That's it.
Good job, buddy.
Good job.
Good job. That's a wrap.
So we got like $2 left in the budget, and it wasn't $2 margarita night. So it's one of those taverns where they put dollar bills on the ceiling. So we're gonna leave a couple dollar bills as souvenirs for Tron and Solly. Hey, that worked out.
All right, there it is.
All right, we're out.
We out, Larry.
Randy, I gotta ask you, how is Neil's psyche?
With
the impending fight looming.
I'm training for a charity boxing match called Haymakers for Hope.
He was good, he was a little afraid. The training, the hours was taking a little bit of a toll on him. He's fighting a, you know, pretty yoked, jacked, hairstylist for the celebrities. I think there's a very real possibility Neil could suffer some bodily harm.
If I was just betting on my own, I'd be like, it's hard to bet on Neil at this point.
I think he's gonna rock the dude. Rocked him.
I think Neil's out. I think he's out preparing him, and I think that counts for something.
Danny's my boys.
What's going on? How you doing, man?
What's up, man?
This is DJ.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
No laying up squad. We're getting dialed is what we're doing.
How you feeling?
Feeling great.
What are all the things you have to do before the fight?
I gotta eat a bunch of bananas, a little bit of a RX bar. They get a little sticky in the teeth though, so you gotta wash your mouth out a little bit. Hit some mitts, and then just keep the feet light. We're good.
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna go take a piss. That's my head.
Neil, we'll see you out there, bud.
Go get him, bud.
How you feeling?
Feeling great, man.
Feeling great.
Yeah, a little wet from the weather, but other than that.
Randy?
Great, man. Hey, I'm looking forward to Neil validating this fight. He's won it for, over the last 4 months, he's won this fight.
Neil's right hand is like a damn foghorn.
Leghorn foghorn.
Lights out, Gates.
The kid, I thought he'd be jacked up. The kid was calm. Hey, listen, in all honesty, I hope I have a buddy to go travel with after this.
Fingers crossed.
Itself.
Worst case scenario. Oh my god, here we go.
Oh my god.
This is Neil's opponent.
Yeah! There's nothing else we can do now.
We made it this far.
He's in God's hands now.
Let's go.
He came out.